Come on, let's go outside. Let's take a walk in the sun. There are things to learn and things to see. A big wide world for you, your dog, and me. Dog Talk.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to Dog Talk. I'm Pat Becker. You know my co-host, Rusty. It's good to see all of these dogs here because, obviously, we are a dog show. Bob, you brought your dog. Susan Owen, how are you?
I'm wonderful.
And you have Scout Film Company and produce all of the wonderful videos that we've had. It's just been fantastic. And since this is the year that we are doing the whole Christmas thing, I thought that we would show that video that that was so super that this dog was in. Bob, you were in it too, weren't you?
Yes, I had a couple of roles in it.
And this dog was just, this dog was so cute. But first, you know, you brought us a video today, didn't you?
Yes, about dogs going to the eye doctor.
Ooh,
yes.
Ooh, let's see that.
And how was your day today?
Well, it was like any other day this morning. It started out just seeing patients as always. But then the doctor came in and she informed me we're going to start seeing dogs.
Dogs?
Dogs.
Why are these dogs coming to the eye doctor?
Well, the first one needed prescription sunglasses because she couldn't see the bases when she's playing baseball. One of them came in with a tie on.
A tie on?
Yes. And his deal was he runs agility and he couldn't see the obstacles because his glasses kept falling off. So he got contacts.
Contacts!
And then there was another dog that came in, and he was an artist wearing a little beret. Yeah, and he came in, he was seeing double. He was painting pictures, and he was seeing double. So he had to get some new glasses. And that dog had the nerve to argue with me about the bill on the way out.
No.
You believe it. And then we had the cutest little tricolored black and white and brown dog come in. He was so cute. He was having really bad eye allergies. His eyes were all red and swollen and figured out he's allergic to the cat.
Oh my goodness, those poor eyes.
I know, and he had to get some drops. And then he had to sit out in the waiting room until his eyes cleared up. The day was over and we were through with dogs. In comes two more and came in with some people too. And these people are looking like, what are these dogs doing in here?
Dogs and people.
Dogs and people and the eye doctor. This beautiful Dalmatian come in. This Dalmatian is running for office as a politician.
What?
Yeah. And she can't read the teleprompter because her prescription wasn't right. And it was so hard for her and embarrassing, she'd jump off the podium and leave. So she had to get some new glasses and now she can read the teleprompter. And it's all better now.
I can see why your days was crazy.
And then we had another dog that likes to read, and the glasses kept falling off and frustrating her. She couldn't see good out of them, so she had to get some new, a new prescription. And guess what?
What?
Next week, she informed me, we're going to start seeing cats.
Cats?
Cats.
Like meow?
Yes, like meow cats.
Cats.
Thank you. Well, that was rubbish.
So, as usual, Susan, you have entertained us to the 10th degree. I mean, it's so fantastic.
They
do such great work. How does somebody get in touch with you if they want to, say, have a video made of their dog or something?
I have a website, scoutfilmcompany.com, or you can email me, susan@scoutfilmcompany.com.
Sounds like a good deal. We're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, we're going to talk about the Christmas video that this darling dog was a star. Were you a star? You were in it too, Bob, weren't you? We'll be right back.
K1 Pet Emporium is Oklahoma's authority on healthy nutrition for dogs and cats. Quality does not have to cost more, and we only have the best. If your pet suffers from allergies, digestive issues, skin infections, or hair loss, it may be the result of their diet. A1 Pet Emporium can help. We offer pet portraits monthly, adorable rescue animals every Saturday from noon to 4, and free dog and cat food samples. Locally owned and operated, we want to be your neighborhood pet store.
So one of the videos that we did for Christmas time was kind of one that went back. It was kind of mythical. And you were in it, Bob. You were a guard.
Yes, I was a guard.
And of course, this dog, Napoleon, was a star. And he was so good. And you know what? We have a gift for Napoleon from you. This is from Barking Dog Bakery, which makes fantastic little baskets like this. Go in there. It's on May Avenue, not too far from Bilbao, as a matter of fact. Right. But these are wonderful gifts that I think that you will enjoy. Barking Dog Bakery.
Sure he will.
So, so we are going to watch this film, and I think everyone will enjoy it. It's got Robin Hood in it. It's got Napoleon in it. It's just, watch this.
This looks so great.
It is. Oh, it's beautiful.
It is. It's
so
just
pretty.
Precious.
It's very
I love
different.
It. You did a great job.
Yeah,
hey, just had maybe some color.
What are you guys doing?
We're decorating.
Okay, we've got to go. It's the Christmas show. Santa Claus is on his way.
We've got to finish.
We've got
so many
things to do.
Okay. Oh, geez.
Ho, ho, ho!
Santa!
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 Claus!
Santa!
Gifts for everyone!
Oh my gosh! Yay! How wonderful! Look at that! Come on, guys. Here we go. Pass them all out. Get them all out. There we go. Right. We're not good. Sure.
Yep. I gave them each one.
Great. Everybody gets one. Did you want that?
Yes, say
yes. Did you get a dog?
We're going to take a quick break, folks, and when we come back, Santa has a story for us. So stick around. Yay!
Jingle bedtime, snowing and blowing, our bushels of fun.
So this is, as you can tell, our Christmas show. This is a time for reflection for us. Everybody that we have worked with through the year, what happiness that we have been receiving from everybody, from you, the viewers. It's been wonderful to have you give us the emails, talk to us on our Facebooks, and let us know what you want to see. We try very hard to educate and entertain at the same time. And speaking of entertainment, I understand that Santa, you have a story to tell?
Yes, I do. I have a story to tell.
Once upon a time, in a mythical kingdom, there lived a very kind king named Carl, who had a beautiful daughter named Catherine. Living in the palace was very special for Catherine, but she was, on occasion, very lonesome. Her wish was to have a pet companion, a dog of her very own to love and care for. Her father told her to plan in December on her 14th birthday to attend an event at which she could select a favorite breed. The day had arrived, and a procession of the kingdom's most beautiful dogs paraded across the courtyard. The princess loved them all and couldn't choose between them. The king wisely told Catherine to think carefully, and perhaps in a few days she could decide. Early one morning, the princess awoke to the sound of sleigh bells, and Santa appeared, holding a little dog named Tug. Santa told Catherine that the pup had been found wandering through the village streets and needed a home. The princess took the pup to her father and convinced him to adopt the precious dog. All was well. Catherine and her new friend Tug were so happy and played every day. However, one day, Tug escaped the palace through an open door and ran into the woods. It could have been a tragic adventure, but lucky for Tug, he was spotted by Robin Hood. And through the magic of the microchip, the brave Robin returned the anxious pup to the princess. The king was so impressed with all of the different breeds of dogs presented to the princess, he bought all of them and made them companions to his court. And everyone lived happily ever after.
Person looked a lot like you.
No.
Well, we appreciate you telling us that story, Santa, and
you're
including
welcome.
Catherine. Now, Catherine, that was a long time ago. They had microchips?
Yes, you know, microchips are so important. I think
absolutely. And I see that what you're saying, adoption is very, very important.
Very important.
And although we do appreciate the purebred dogs and the breeders who breed them, who try to make them better and better and better, that's something that we can appreciate. The adoptions are so important. Mm-hmm. And if they're lost and that microchip is on there, good lesson learned. Mm-hmm. We thank you, Santa.
You're welcome.
We're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, we're going to visit with Bill Bonadio and Sherry Lanier. Going to do some cooking for your dogs.
Hey.
That's a cute one. That's a darling dog.
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
And it is the most wonderful time of the year, folks. This is our Christmas show, as I say. And we are so grateful to our friends, our viewers, our sponsors. Everything has been so fantastic. How has your been?
My year's been wonderful.
Yes?
I've been very blessed. Moved from one location just down the street to another. I've lost a little dog and gained another, and just absolutely had a wonderful, wonderful year. Nice, wonderful experiences. New customers, of course, new faces, new flavors, just
you would just keep going on and on and on with this beautiful stuff. So how about you, Bill? How was your year been?
We had a great year this year. You know, this is our 35th year that we're celebrating since 1979. We're the oldest family-owned Italian restaurant in Oklahoma City, owned
for
by
Bill
real Italian.
For Bonadio's?
Yep, the Bonadio family. It's, I am a third-generation restaurateur, so I'm still
from New
practicing.
York?
From Toyd Bonadio store.
I love it. Well, but we're always teasing you about that, but we are so grateful that you're here. Both of you have contributed so much, and
thank
we really appreciate it. So what are we going to cook for Christmas?
Well, one of the big things that people ask me about during the Christmas season, obviously, number one, is my lasagna trays. I sell just a scant amount of lasagna trays.
I don't know about lasagna for dogs.
I know. Lasagna's not good for dogs, but the other thing that I enjoy besides lasagna is prime rib, and I usually always have
now,
some.
Now, my dog would love some prime rib.
Well, when what we do with a lot of the end cuts, because a lot of people like their prime rib, medium rare mostly, for people that are vegetarians.
Oh, yes.
So we have a lot of end cuts left. So what we're going to do is we're going to make a steak dinner today with some prime rib tips and some mashed potatoes and green beans.
Well, that sounds wonderful, but I caught the word mistake.
No, there was no mistake.
Oh,
it was end cuts. Yes, steak.
It's New York accent again. You've got to kind of be specific.
So anyway, so what all we have in here is the little ends pieces of the prime rib, which you'll have usually the end cuts nobody likes because they're well done. So we put a little bit of olive oil in the pan, and we've got our pieces in there. We're going to go ahead and thicken it up and make a nice gravy with just a little bit of a slurry, which is a little bit of flour and water. Thicken it up. And believe it or not, Gravy Master, which is a thickener and a browner, you can just add just a tad. And the only thing bad about that is it's got a little bit of sugar in it, and it's okay to have a little sugar for your dog, but you know, it's okay. It's kind of like a treat, somewhat.
Yep.
And
look at that. Catherine, are you a cook at all?
Sometimes, yeah, I love to cook.
No kidding. Yeah, I'm impressed.
I was just saying, you know, I love the little dog treats they have. I love making food for my dog and treats. And
oh, how wonderful is that? Well, then you can get some good little tips here.
That looks delicious.
It does look delicious.
All right. So now we just. And this is better than gravy train, so.
Oh, heavens.
Yeah, I can imagine it would be. If that's prime rib, I'd say it's up there.
Okay.
So what are you going to add to that?
Well, you know, we have always leftovers when you have everyone over at the house. You have mashed potatoes, you have green beans, you've got your prime rib, and of course, you'll have to make the gravy special for your dog.
Okay.
Because usually your gravies are going to have way too much salt in it, and some of the other
ingredients no salt.
May not
go
with them.
That's not
so we're
good.
Just going to go ahead and fill our little.
Well, what is this little nest that you have down there?
Just this is mashed potatoes, and all it is some fresh potatoes.
Oh, my gosh.
Mashed up.
It's its own little bowl here.
It is, and then we're going to go ahead and we're going to put the French green beans on there.
Oh,
there
so
we
how
go.
Elegant is that?
Wow.
That's it.
Now,
very
this,
cute.
That is unbelievable. Mm-hmm. That
if your dog
is,
turns his nose up to that, oh, well.
I don't think my dogs would. I don't think they'd ever eat anything canned again, but then I'd be pretty much out of business. So at any rate, that is gorgeous. And how long does this take? It doesn't take very long to do.
No, as long as it took us, 3 or 4 minutes, it's something that you can whip up from your leftovers.
Good Lord, that is
great.
Amazing.
Well,
Catherine,
just,
there you go. So tell us about the treats.
Well, what we could do is we could not top that off by any means, but we could have...
Well, I don't know. Some of my dogs would probably rather have something like that.
Well, gosh, we could go with a piece of cake on top of that, or we could go ahead and just do a snickerpoodle, which is... like a snickerdoodle cookie with
sugar. And keep in mind, too, folks, that these things that Sherry fixed are edible for humans.
Definitely. No preservatives,
so what
no
appeals
salt
to you,
sugar.
Catherine, over here?
Oh, I was eyeing this little cake right here.
Well, let's take that
little gorgeous.
Take you want to take
cake.
A little bite and see what
goodness.
It's like?
Dog treat.
Uh-huh.
Wow, it tastes like normal cake. That's crazy.
It's cream cheese and honey for the
cream
actual icing.
Cream cheese and honey.
Wow.
So, you know. Little,
I'm loving that.
I love the writing on it.
Oh, dude, because it says dog talk.
Well, if you
little
wanted to
detail.
Bypass, well, thank you. If you wanted to bypass not so much just the cake, you could focus on healthier type things. And, you know, it might be they're going to be really full from eating that. You could give them one of the sweet potato dehydrated
and these
sweet
are the
potatoes.
Sweet potatoes.
And
they almost look like bones.
Yeah, it does.
And
they're
hardened. So this would be, this would be very good to clean your dog's teeth, fellas.
Yeah, fantastic. Vitamin C
excellent.
For them, obviously.
Yes,
sure.
It is.
Well, then you could also focus on, you know, if you, once they rest from that and they're ready a little bit more, have something else, we could offer them sweet potato and pumpkin just to keep on with that healthy
and what are
move.
These?
These are wonderful. They're going to be pumpkin mixed with peanut butter and flavor. with nice little fun decorations on top, and we have a variety of if you want to do like a setting of sorts, you could have every type of Christmas figure, if you want to focus on that, mm-hmm. for the family on top. And we have our flavored snickerpoodles in a variety of different colors to
These. Look at these, Catherine. If that isn't adorable.
And little Santa and a snowman.
And it has egg protein for the actual coloring. So
excellent. I'm loving this.
Well,
and these,
you.
What are they?
Well, these are an all-natural dehydrated turkey hearts. So once again, you're going to get your high protein. Not focusing on what they just consumed, but if you follow along with your dehydrated and or your freeze-dried proteins mixed with, of course, your different vitamins. I'm going to say, let's use sweet potato as a vitamin.
Yes.
For the fiber and the vitamin C's and such. So then, you know, once again, brush your teeth with the vegetables and vegetable-based products.
And there you go. Well, this is remarkable. Now, what's in the can?
Once again, it's put out by Merrick, and Merrick has, this time of year is wonderful. They have seasonal, several different seasonal recipes. This happens to be turducken, which is, once again, the turkey and several different vegetables involved with it.
Right.
So
you know, and the thing about it, folks, is that this is so wonderful. These are the things you should be feeding your dog. At Christmas time, there's so much around that you should not be feeding your dog. Like what, Catherine?
Chocolate.
That's a biggie.
Whatsoever.
Yeah, things that can constrict, too. Big bones and even little bones. Turkey bones are no-no-nos. And things like things that are very, very high in fiber that we can digest easily, but dogs can't. Too many carbs, you know, is not good. And sometimes you have just candies laying out, you know. And this is why the veterinarians have to work on Christmas sometimes, you know. They do not like that a lot. But it is so easy, folks, to do the right thing. And this is what we're talking about. So, Sherry, where can we find these?
Well, you can find us on May Cluster Hefner. We're at 10455 North May. It's in the Village Park Center, and we're actually neighbors with Bill.
Bill Bonadio. There you go.
That's right. We're just down the street at 10712 North May.
Yes.
And we make some pretty good Italian food, I've been told.
Absolutely. So are we going to be able to get this if we go in? I can take my dog? What?
Well, you can take your dog, but
I'd
have to make a doggy bag for them.
I just love teasing you about that. It is a great place to eat. Both places are great. Folks, you know, do the right thing. Buy the right food. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back.
All right.
Here's a recap of our year, folks. Have a great one. Have a Merry Christmas. And check our Facebook. We've got some changes for Dog Talk. I think you'll like it.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. May your hearts be light. Christmas joys keep our troubles out of sight. Have yourself a merry, merry Christmas. Keep the Yuletide gay. A toast to loved ones who are far away. Here we are as in olden days, happy golden days of yore. Dear to us, gather near to us once more. Through the years, may we always be together, the fates allow. Hang a shining star above the highest bough, and have yourself a very merry Christmas now. Each year we celebrate, we give gifts and decorate for the season. We must always remember that sharing love is the holiday's real reason. Through the years, we may always be together if the fates allow. Hang a shining star above the highest bough, and have yourself the merriest of Christmases
above. Then a year or two later, you fell out of love. You dumped them, man, and kicked them out. Now what the heck was that about? Dogs. Oh, we're talking about dogs. Dogs. Them poor little dogs. Talking about big dogs. Uh-huh. Talking about a little dog. Oh, yeah. Chasing the ball, chasing the cat, digging the hole.